competent in gatherers. The patterns appear to be random, but I think they're very, I think they're thoughtful. Hey guys, come over here, sit over here. Because there's an opportunity to see you on camera, I think everybody will want to see you on camera.
Because we're like this the whole time. So it is fun. All right, who here likes pro football? Ooh, did you? I was talking to you about that earlier. What's your name?
Marielle.
Marielle sits in the chair because her dress is pretty. Although your dress is pretty too. So, who's your favorite football team?
Chargers.
Steelers. Raising them right. Who else has another football team here? So, interestingly enough, I have a favorite football team, and it happens to be the Pittsburgh Steelers. And so we're going to tell a quick story about the Steelers in the Super Bowl against, what team was mentioned? Redskins. So that's really a famous team. So the Steelers are playing the Redskins, the Steelers win, and Troy Polamalu, who has crazy hair, is interviewed afterwards. So let's see, who wants to be Troy Polamalu? Of course. I should put this on your head. Okay, mommy, don't look. Okay, here. Because you're so pretty, I want to mess with you. Ready? Okay, we'll just lay it there. So come here, Troy. So Troy Polamalu, you just won the Super Bowl, so what are you going to do now?
I'm going to go to Disney World.
We didn't do this beforehand. We didn't practice this. Okay, thank you, Troy. Oh, look, you're a beautiful Troy. You're a beautiful Troy. You're beautiful Troy. So anyway, now, there's something that's interesting. I was talking to Chaplain Munroy before this. In the Bible, there is a story of Jesus talking to a rich young ruler. Who knows that story? Right? So the story of the rich young ruler, right? The rich young ruler. So this rich young ruler comes up to Jesus and says, Lord, I want to follow you. What do I do? says, well, you just follow my commandments. Just, and he goes, no worries, I've got that covered. I follow all of them, name them. So he names off a few. Jesus, I've been doing that all my life. We're good to go. So where are we headed next? He goes, well, before we can do that, he also said one other thing. What did Jesus say to him? So sell everything, all your possessions, and give that them to the poor. Well, the rich young ruler, he also got cold feet, right? And he went away so very disappointed. Now, Chaplin said, Jesus looked over to his disciples, and he said to his disciples, how about you guys? Are you guys leaving too? And they said, no, Lord, we're following you. We love and have faith, and we trust you. Now, the Bible is full of wonderful, wonderful heroes that made a decision for God, and God has used them. Can you think of who are your Bible heroes? Do you have a Bible hero? Think about it. Oh, you do? Who?
Jesus.
You can't beat that one. That's the best one. Who else?
David.
Oh, I like that one. David.
Daniel.
Daniel. Very good. Oh, my gosh. I thought you were raising your hand. Anybody else have a Bible hero? Moses is a pretty good one. Right, there are other Bible heroes too. There's so many. Samson, Ruth, I mean, so many, right? Who's the queen who's really been made up her life? Esther the queen. Now, do you think, so, come stand up here again. Now, let's say you're Esther the queen, okay? Now, Jesus has come, right? Now, you stand over here. Now, Jesus has come, and someone, and a news reporter like me comes up to you and says, Queen Esther, Queen Esther, Jesus, God has said that you have been faithful and you love the Lord. What are you going to do next?
I'm going to go to heaven.
Oh, we didn't practice that at all. That was wonderful. Yes. So isn't it better? Isn't it better for God to say to us, well done, a faithful servant? And then we get to say, instead of going to Disney World, because it can get really unbearable there at times, we get to say, we're going to heaven because of our love and our faith and our trust in the Lord. Who here wants to go to heaven? What's the best way to get there? Who knows? Who knows the best way?
Listening to God's Ten Commandments.
That's a good one, yes. What else?
Have a relationship with Him.
Wow, okay guys, have a relationship with Him. The best way to have a relationship with God is what?
Read the Bible.
Read the Bible, and what else? Pray.
Trust Him.
So, with that, are we prepared to pray and get to know Jesus? Are we all prepared to do that?
Yes.
That's wonderful. So, with prayer, who wants to pray for us today? Hold on. Let's see. Did I use you last time? Was that a hand up, or are you shooting away a fly, or shooting away Christopher? Oh, okay. You want to pray?
Sophie had her hand up.
Oh, where's Sophie? Where? Oh, she knows. Do you want to pray? Come here.
I will do it. Precious.
Compassion on her. He said to her, do not weep. Luke 7:13. The author writes, in 2007, there was a horrific bus accident near Maluti Adventist Hospital in Lesotho. I wrote a newsletter article entitled Healing Hands Through the Night, which I sent out about the compassion of the doctor in charge and the staff at Maluti Hospital, who cared for the injured survivors. One reader in Australia had compassion when she read about the children who had lost parents in the accident and sent money to help. Lesotho is sometimes called the Mountain Kingdom and has very cold winters. The winter approaching, the chief and the caregivers decided that the greatest need was shoes. So time was spent identifying the 46 orphans and getting their shoe sizes amid tears and sad faces. One lost-looking father was holding the youngest of his five children. Having lost his wife, he had to rely on the eldest daughter, Mabatsi, age 13, to give the shoes sizes. Let us give with compassion today as we remember those who have lost much. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray for this offering that it may bring comfort to whoever needs it. I hope, Lord, that we can help those who need it to be helped, and for them to realize that you are here for them. They are never alone. And we pray, amen.
This is the time for us to offer our request for prayer. If you have had a chance to write your request, please bring it forward to this basket, and our team during the midweek will be praying for them, as well as the pastor. And as you make the request for prayer, since you pray, please remember once again the 2-month-old niece of Denise Curry, who is having to fight a meningitis at Duke University Hospital. Let's sing our prayer song.
Thank you.
thank you for this beautiful Sabbath day. This is, again, the first of Sabbath of the summer. And as the weather changes, we know that you will not change, that you will be loving us, that you will be taking care of us. Help us to remain steadfast for you and to share our blessings that we have received from you with others. At this time, we have a special request for the niece of Denise Curry. She is 2 months old and suffering with meningitis. Be with her, be with her body, be with her mother and father, be with her family, and be with the medical team. We know that you are in charge, you are the great physician, and that you will do what is best for her. Help us to accept the fact that you are still in control. As we pray here, we also ask prayer for safety of our members, the ones that are in camp meeting. May they receive the same blessing, because we know wherever we are, you are with us. As we are here, as we go to our homes, help us to be given opportunities and to take those opportunities to share your love with them. Be with Chaplain Monroy and his family. We thank you for the blessings they've been with us, as you can see and hear. The family is involved, and help us to see them as an example of what we can do with our families. Be with Chaplain Monroy as he delivers us your message to us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Today's scripture reading is found in John chapter 6, verses 66 through 69. At this point, many of his disciples turned away and deserted him. Then Jesus turned to the 12 and asked, "Are you also going to leave?" Simon Peter replied, "Lord, to whom would we go? You have the words that give eternal life. We believe and we know you are the Holy One of God."
Amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
Many times when we're in the midst of a storm or a difficulty and we're having a really hard time, seeing our way out, trying to find a solution to our problems, we forget that we have someone there that is waiting to come to him with whatever we may be going through. He says, "Come all ye who are
heavy laden,
and I will give you rest." And it's sometimes in the midst of that's when we discover and we feel his hand and his blessings. May the Lord be with you today, and may you be able to find that peace and that rest in him.